Eddie Murphy blew up on Saturday Night Live in 1980, playing unforgettable characters like Buckwheat, Gumby, and Mr. Robinson.
That's where my roots are, Saturday Night Live.
He then clobbered the box office with 48 Hours, Trading Places, and Beverly Hills Cop.
Classic Eddie Murphy.
And stood out at stand-up with Delirious and Raw.
Very few people can wear purple and red leather suits and then continue in this business afterwards.
But Eddie's Hollywood adventure was just taking off.
I was young. And I didn't know anything different. It was just like, okay, you're supposed to go from 48 Hours of Trading Places to Saturday Night Live. And I was touring back then too. So now when I look back on it, I trip off it. But back then it was just, you know, business as usual.
Ever since, business has boomed.
I've had an audience for almost 25 years, and you know, and this is a business where people come and go.
Despite his quarter century credentials, Eddie admits there's no foolproof formula for success.
Usually the movie you think is gonna be, oh, this is gonna be the one! This is gonna kill him! And that one goes in the toilet. Pluto Nash came out, I was like, yeah! I'm getting ready to kick ass! Pluto Nash, baby!
He's passed on some big winners.
Rush Hour, I was supposed to do that one. I was supposed to be in Who Shot Roger Rabbit. He came to me and said, hey, you in animation? And I was like, what are you, a maniac? Never! When we were making Trading Places, Dan Aykroyd said, oh, man, I'm writing this movie about ghosts. And I was like, that sounds like a crock of shit to me.
But mischances haven't scarred him.
Because I'm a karate man bleed on the inside. We don't show our weaknesses.
This year, Eddie received long-awaited critical acclaim with an Oscar nomination for Dreamgirls.
To be in something that's this relevant, just is a great feeling.
But please, don't call it a comeback.
My last movie made $900 million worldwide.
And now I'm coming back.
It's always a comeback with me.
And he'll keep coming back, thanks to his ability to make us laugh.
The one thing that remains consistent from Saturday Night Live to me doing stand-up comedy to being in the movies is my sense of humor. That's my gift, is that I can be funny.